everybody, Lambie here, and today we're going to be making an indoor terrarium. And if you don't know what a terrarium is, you're about to find out, guys. So behind me here, we have various plants that we've selected to be in our terrarium. Now, we don't know if they're all going to fit or not, and if they don't, that's okay too, because we're going to be doing another project in a while that you'll see that one too. But anyway, let's get started, and I want to show you some of these plants. Now, it's kind of noisy out here today. The neighbors are outside because the weather's really nice, and there's lots of planes flying over, so I'm going to be doing a voiceover, guys. So anyway, let's get started. I'll get out of the way so Mom can show you the plants.
Okay, guys, so what we have here is a nice pink plant, and I knew Lambie would like it because of the leaves, and it's called a hypoestis. And so it's very fluffy and pink and very pretty, and we know Lambie loves pink, so we got that one. And then over here we have a prayer plant, and the reason it is called a prayer plant is because at nighttime the leaves close up and the plant itself actually moves around. So that's pretty cool. And then we have this one, which is a mini peace lily, and it is the smallest peace lily I've ever seen. You can see the flower, and yeah, so it's a little mini peace lily, and I thought it was adorable. And then this one is a little fern. It's just a little generic fern, and we'll just add that to add some greenery and everything to it. And then we have here an African violet plant, and it blooms these pretty flowers, and so I'm very excited, and the soft leaves, so we chose that one. So it's called golden Scottish moss, and it's very pretty green and fluffy, but I don't know if we'll have room for it, so there we go.
Okay, guys, now we're going to take a look at the supplies that you're going to need.
So first, you're going to need a glass container. This one I got at a craft store, and it's supposed to be for like a, you know, put a candle inside or something. So it has a nice wide opening. So we wanted to use that one. So we're going to use that. You can use a cookie jar. You can use a pickle jar. You can use an old fish bowl, anything like that, but a glass container. And then we're going to have rocks. So you need rocks to put at the very bottom, so that way the water that you water the plants with has a place to drain to. And then this one is optional. You don't have to get this. It's activated filter carbon, and you can get this at a pet store, and people use this for aquariums to clean the water. You don't need it, but what it does is it keeps the soil from smelling and it keeps it fresh. So that would be good to have if you could get it. And then we have, of course, soil, organic soil. So it doesn't have to be organic. Any soil will work, but that's the soil that we're going to use inside. So there's the main supplies. So these are optional supplies. You don't have to have these. These are aquarium gravel, and it's just tiny little rocks that you can decorate with. And this isn't necessary, but it would be helpful. And then here I just have a little cup of various rocks and crystals and things that I have that are very pretty, and they're decorative. So you can use those inside there to decorate. And then this I got at a pet store. This is actually a hermit crab dish for like food or water or something, but it's going to be acting as a pond that I thought would be very cute. So this stuff is optional. So let's get started. You're going to take your glass container, whatever you chose to use, and you're going to take that, and then you're going to take your rocks, and the rocks need to be poured into the bottom very gently so you don't break anything, and you just pour those in there, and what that's going to do is that is going to help the water have a place to drain to, so that way the soil that your plants are in doesn't get rotted and gross, and it actually is good for the plants if the soil has a place to drain. So the water will go down inside those rocks at the very bottom. So you just spread those out like so. There we go, and I think that's enough. I'll just use that amount right now. Yeah, there's not holes in the bottom, so when you water the plants, the water can evaporate down into the bottom and have a place to go to keep it away from the roots of the plants. This activated filter carbon, and this removes waste, colors, and odors. So what it's going to do in here is it's going to keep the soil from being rotted, and it's going to keep the soil fresh and get rid of any odors. So you can see that it's just black carbon. So we're going to sprinkle that in and sprinkle that a layer over all of the rocks, so that way the rocks are separate from the soil. Then I'm going to take more of the rocks and just lay it around the edge just for extra drainage. This is optional. You don't have to do this part, but I just thought that I would add them right around the edge just for extra drainage. Alright guys, so now what we're going to do is take the soil. We have organic soil, so it's nice and fresh since it's going to be indoors. And it just pours out like that. It's very fine and very nice soil. And you just pour it in, and then what we're going to do is we're going to spread it out a little bit. Just cover the rocks and just spread it out. Spread it out nice like that. We'll probably have to be adding more soil, but it's good so far. Alright, so the first one we're going to do is the African violet, and we're just going to take it out of its little pot, and what probably will have to happen is I think it's going to be too big for the inside of here. So what we might have to do is break off some of the leaves, because I don't know if it'll fit. Oh, okay, guys, what happened just there is a bee flew and landed on my hand, and the bee is flying all over, and it's on the flowers of the African violet. So I was like assaulted by a bee. So I'm bringing it to the camera. I'm very brave here, and there's a bee on the African violet. So we just have to kind of let it sit there until the bee decides to go away, because I am not touching it. So there's the bee. Yeah, scared me to death. Oh my gosh, seriously, it scared me to death. I couldn't believe it, because it landed on my hand first, and that's why I dropped the plant. So I really hope the plant's okay, but scared me to death, guys. Just was not even funny. So yeah, there's the bee.
Well, guys, you never know what's going to happen when you're making a Lambie video. I cannot believe that just happened. A bee flew over, landed on Mom's hand, and then jumped over to the plant. That's why it scared her and she dropped it. Oh my goodness, guys. I hope the plant's okay. Can we continue now, Mom?
Yeah, I hope it's okay too, but that bee scared me. That's why I dropped it.
All right, let's continue so we can get it in the soil before something happens to it.
Okay, let me get it. So now what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to position this little dish here how I want it in there. And I have that where I want it. So now I am going to be using the aquarium gravel, which are just tiny little rocks. I'm going to be using those. Oops. I'm going to be using those to make kind of like a pathway to the pond. I want it to kind of look like it's coming out from the plants a little bit. So that way it... looks like it's a little path leading into a forest or something. So now I'm gonna add this rose quartz. So there's the rose quartz. Gotta figure out where I want it. I think I wanna put it right there. And then I'm gonna put a couple more rocks, but some of the rocks are too big, so you have to figure out what rocks go where. Lambie, what do you think?
I think it's turning out really nice, Mom. It's so pretty. I love this thing.
So we're going to take some of these other rocks that I have, and we're just going to place some of the smaller ones just in various areas, just to kind of give it a little bit of decoration here and there. So I really like this rock here. I got this at Malibu Beach when we went with Grammy for Mother's Day, so I want to put that in there. So there it is. So instead of using the watering can to water everything, I'm going to be using this dropper. You can get this at Rite Aid, CVS, Walgreens, any kind of pharmacy like that. And I'm going to be using that to water the plants, so that way I can control how much water is being poured into here. Because you've got to be careful how much you water it, because remember, there's not any drainage holes in the bottom. So I'm just going to be using this dropper like so, at the base of each plant, so that way I can make sure that they get a drink of water. So as you can see, I am now going to be filling up this little dish with water, so that way it looks like it's a little pond, and you can get a good close-up shot of all my rocks and things here. So I'm just going to fill that up, and it just looks like a little pond. I think it's adorable. Lambie, come take a look.
Alright guys, so there is our indoor terrarium, and yeah, we'll show you in a minute where we're going to put it. But there it is, guys, and it has a little pond. That's what that little rock thing was Mom was filling up. And then we took the little rocks. Mom, can you point?
Yeah, sure.
We took those little rocks over there, and we made a pathway, so it kind of goes off into what looks like a forest. Isn't that neat, guys? Isn't it so pretty? And then we put some rocks and the crystal, and I'm very proud of it, Mom. Thank you so much for making it.
You're welcome, sweetie. I just hope they live. I don't know if this thing is deep enough, but we'll give it a try and we'll see. And if they start to die, we'll have to make sure we take them out and replant them somewhere.
Yeah, it sounds like a plan, Mom. It's beautiful, guys. It's going to be so peaceful at our desk. So let's show them where we're going to put it.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, guys, so here it is on our desk. And yeah, isn't it pretty, guys? Let's do a closer look. Oh, with the rocks and the gems and the plants. Mom, I really hope it lives.
I know, Lambie, but I said that if it started to, if anything started to die, we would take it out and replant it in a bigger pot or something. But people use these in terrariums all the time, so I hope that it works.
Yeah, me too, Mom. This is so neat. I like the little pond that you created. There's actually water in there, guys. I like that a lot, and then I like the rock path. Very cool and very pretty. I like those leaves. They're pink. Anyway, guys, do you have one of these in your house? Have you ever made one? I think they're so pretty, and I'm so proud to have it displayed right here on my desk. I hope you enjoyed this video, everyone, and I had a lot of fun watching Mom do it.
Yeah, you're just chicken because you don't want to get dirt on your fur.
Yeah, no dirt on my fur. That would be bad. Anyway, guys, let me know. Do you guys want to make one of these? Have you ever made one of these? Do you have one of these? Let me know in a comment below. Like this video if you like my terrarium. Talk to you later, guys. Bye.